in the digital communication, now I would like to tell about the books, textbooks, or reference books for the subject. So there are two books which I refer for the textbooks. So it's the Communication System by Simon Higgins and the Modern Digital and Analog Communication System by B.P. Larkin. These two books I will refer to cover the 60% of the subject, and other digital communication by Proclus, Digital Communication Fundamentals and Applications, Bernard Sklar, Principle of Communication by E. Zimmer and William S. Tranter as a reference book. This is the diagram which describes the whole digital communication. Basically, digital communication is non-digital communication. Any communication is consists of three blocks, three important blocks. One is the transmitter, then channel, and last one the receiver block. Here also, the communication system consists of transmitter, receiver, and channel is similar to which I used for the analog communication. And digital communication is characterized by the information theory encoding. Basically, information theory encoding defines what is information, what is the definition of information, and what is the mutual information, what is the entropy, what is the channel capacity, what is the channel capacity theorem, what is the source coding. Basically, here there is two vectors are added in the digital communication compared to analog communication. In analog communication, the first block is the information sources. Information sources basically generate the continuous time signal, and this signal is modulated with the high frequency carrier, and finally this modulated signal is transmitted through the channel. But here before transmission, now there are two extra blocks are added. First block is the information sources which generate the electrical signal, and this electrical continuous time signal, and this continuous time signal is converted into discrete form by using A to D converter. A to D converter, basically this involves three processes. First process is the sampling. Sampling will convert analog signal or continuous time signal into discrete form. Discrete form means signal defined only discrete time. Now this discrete signal means this is discrete amplitude at discrete time. Now then this discrete signal is quantized. The other process of A to D conversion is the quantization. In quantization, basically the sampled signal is divided into number of levels. For example, suppose this is the continuous time signal. This is the continuous time signal. Suppose this is the MD. MD is the basic signal or information signal. And this is the clock pulse or carrier signal. Suppose this is the TV. TV is the clock pulse, or this is the pulse train. Frequency of this modulated signal is FM. Then frequency of this signal is suppose XP. This is the pulse train. After modulation, suppose ST is the modulated signal, this is equal to MT into CT. After modulation, you will get This is the process of sampling. This is the sample signal. Now this sample is quantized. Quantized means this is the sample value. Now this is divided. The sample value is divided by the number of level. That is known as the quantization level. Suppose this is level 1, level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. And 0 means 0 level, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, level 5. Then we have to compare this exact values, this exact value sample with the nearest level. Third number, suppose this is, this sample value is very near to level 0. And this is near to L1. This is very near to again L1. This is the very near to L4. This sample amplitude is very near to L5. Yes, so this process is known as the quantization process. The first sample, suppose this is of sample first, sample second. The sample first is denoted by the level 4. Sample second is denoted by the level 5. Sample third is again, suppose this is L4. L4. Next sample is L1. L0. L1. So this is L4, L5, L4, L1, L0, L1. These are the quantization level which represent the different samples. So this is the sample signal, this is the quantization level. Now third process is known as encoding. So A to D conversion involves three processes. Sampling, in sampling basically continuous time signal into represent in the discrete form. Discrete time, discrete amplitude signal, this process is known as sampling. Other process is quantization. This sample signal is divided into number of levels. This is the process of quantization, and this L4, L5, something is known as quantization level. And third process is the encoding. In encoding, basically this quantization level is represent the number of bits. And the number of bits depends upon the number of quantization levels. Here, L0 to L5, how many levels? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 levels. So how many bits are required to represent the level? 2 to the power 3 equals to 8. Means 0 to 8. 0 to 8 levels can be represented by 3 bits. Yes? So now represent these levels into the 3 bit form. L4 level means this quantity. This decimal number 4, 5, 4, 1, 0, 1. This is represented by the binary data with the 3 bits. 4, 4 is represented by how many? 1, 0, 0. Then 5, 1, 0, 1. 4, 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0, 1. 0, 0, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0. Now, I'm going to discuss the frequency spectrum or frequency band just used for the communication purpose. So first frequency band is named as a very low frequency band. Very low frequency band, the frequency ranges from 3 kHz to 30 kHz. When you find, when you calculate the wavelength, basically wavelength calculated by this formula, lambda equals to C by F. That C is the unit of light, that 3 to 10 power 8 meter per second. And F is the applied frequency. If you are using 3 kHz, you will get the 100 km of the wavelength. When you are using frequency of the 30 kHz, you will get 10 km of the wavelength. And the transmission medium used for the very low frequency is the wire line transmission medium. Wire line transmission medium means transmitter and receiver are connected with some physical medium. That medium may be the water, may be the copper cable, may be the air. Basically, the application of the very low frequency band is used for the navigation purpose or the transmission purpose, or it is generally used for the telegraphy and the telephony system. This also used for the telegraph or telephone. Now other frequency bands, known as low frequency band, its frequency ranges from 30 to 300 kHz. When you apply this formula, you will get the wavelength ranges from 10 km to 1 km. And the transmission medium is used for the low frequency band is again the grounded wave transmission. The grounded wave transmission are for the transmission purpose, you can also use the air, water and the copper cable. Basically, this is generally used for the aeronautical communication. Aeronautical transmission or aeronautical communication for the radio beacon and for the ground wave communication. And the third spectrum is same as the medium frequency band. The medium frequency band, the frequency ranges from 300 kHz to 3 MHz. And the wavelength range is 1 km to 100 meters. Here again, uses the transmission medium as a grounded wave. Used for the ground wave communication or generally used for the AM broadcasting. Yeah? What is the frequency range for the AM broadcasting is 535 kHz to 1605 kHz. Now this frequency range comes under the 300 kHz to 3 MHz. Yeah? This is the 535 kHz to 1.605 MHz. So this is the current frequency range for the air transmission. Other application is used for the navigation. So this medium frequency band is also used for the navigation purpose and the ground wave communication. The third frequency band is known as medium frequency band. And fourth frequency band is known as high frequency band. For high frequency band, the frequency range is 3 MHz to 30 MHz and wavelength range is 100 meter to 10 meter. And for the high frequency band, the transmission medium is either you can use air or you can use the copper wire, or you can use the coaxial cable, or you can use the coaxial cable. Basically, this high frequency or very high frequency is under from the sky wave propagation. Now high frequency modulation and very high frequency modulation comes under sky wave propagation. Basically, this is used for transmission medium are used for the high frequency band is basically copper wire or coaxial cable. So this is for what is the application of this high frequency band is basically high frequency communication, citizen band, radio, ionosphere communication. Ionosphere communication means these are the layers in the environment. Ionosphere communication is at the transmitter. The electromagnetic wave goes up to the ionosphere layer and reflected back from ionosphere to the receiver, which are situated at the earth ground. So this is the ionosphere communication. For the ionosphere communication, the frequency of the transmitted signal is less than or equals to 30 MHz. Means below the 30 MHz of the frequency of the signal are needed for the ionosphere communication. So next band is the very high frequency band. For the very high frequency band, the frequency range you can see here 30 MHz to 300 MHz and wavelength range is 10 meter to 1 meter. And the transmission medium is also used as a free space or coaxial cable. This is also comes under the sky wave propagation, and the application of And application of this high frequency band is used for the very, very high frequency television, FM and the mobile communication. So this is used for very high frequency TV, television, FM transmission or FM broadcasting or the mobile phone purpose. So application of very high frequency band is the very high frequency television, FM radio, because we know that the various frequency range for the FM broadcasting or FM transmission is used as 88 MHz to 102 MHz. This is the various frequency range for the FM transmission. And this very high frequency also can use for the mobile. Mobile means channel act as a free space. So this is the application of the very high frequency. The next slide. In the next slide, you can see the other frequency spectrum or frequency band is known as the ultra high frequency, UHF. Ultra high frequency, the frequency range for the ultra high frequency is 300 MHz to 3 GHz. 300 MHz to 3 GHz, and the wavelength range is 1 meter to 10 centimeter. And this is come under the waveguide. Waveguide transmission. Basically, ultra high frequency are used for the waveguide transmission purpose. Yes? So what is the transmission? What type of transmission medium are used to transmit the ultra high frequency? That is, medium is you can use the air, you can use the free space, or you can use the waveguide. High frequency waveguide means rectangular waveguide, circular waveguide, cylindrical waveguide for the transmission of ultra high frequency band. And the application of this UHF is the either it can use as a satellite. The application is ultra high frequency are used for the satellite purpose or television or the mobile purpose. The satellite communication, TV transmission or mobile communication can use this ultra high frequency range. And next frequency band is SHF. SHF means super high frequency or extra high frequency band. The frequency range, for this SHF is 3 GHz to 30 GHz. Now this is also come under the waveguide transmission. This is also come under the waveguide transmission. And the transmission medium is used for the super high frequency is again here free space or waveguide or coaxial cable also used.